Dear all, in this session, I'll be discussing about the simulation of impulse voltage generator. We can perform the simulation of impulse voltage generator with the help of virtual lab of IIT Kharagpur. I'll be showing you how to perform the simulation of impulse voltage generator with the help of virtual lab of IIT Kharagpur. First and foremost thing, you need to open your browser. First, you have to type virtual lab IIT Kharagpur and just go for Google search. Now you will be getting IIT Kharagpur virtual lab. You will be getting the option IIT Kharagpur virtual lab. Please click on this. You can click IIT Kharagpur virtual lab. Now web page will be appearing. It is an initiative of MHRD. Then you will be getting the details, then institute details, then details regarding virtual lab. In that virtual lab, lot of laboratories are formulated, like technology CAT laboratory, virtual laboratory on multi-phase flow, virtual lab on mine ventilation, virtual laboratory for simulation and gaming, mechanisms and robotics lab, then virtual high voltage lab. Our requirement is virtual high voltage lab. Please do click on virtual high voltage lab. Then I'll be clicking on virtual high voltage laboratory. In that you will be having lot of options like introduction, then list of experiment, frequently asked questions, then references, technology used, people and feedback. What is the requirement? I need to show you how to conduct the simulation of impulse voltage generator with the help of laboratory. So initially they have given the introduction details. Why high voltage laboratory is required? What is the need for high voltage laboratory? This theory I already explained in my previous lecture videos. You can go through that. They have explained very clearly. You can observe the waveform of impulse voltage generator, then the theory behind impulse voltage generator, why impulse voltage generator is required. Basically, why high voltage laboratory is required means mainly for testing purpose. For the testing purpose only, we will be mainly depending on high voltage laboratory. What is the requirement of high voltage laboratory? They have explained point wise. So this you can read out. Similarly, in IIT Kharagpur, they are having the facilities like laboratories of 75 feet, 50 feet and 45 feet, the basic dimensions of the area. Then different requirements, as well as applications are available there. Different checklists are given, okay, that you can go through. Then the applications of high voltage engineering, that is also explained very clearly. I have the videos regarding these applications like electrostatic precipitator, electrostatic painting or coating, then electrostatic copying or electrostatic printing. Those applications I have explained. You can watch my previous videos. The hyperlink I will be displaying in my description box. You can go through that. Why virtual high voltage laboratory is needed? Why? Because you can perform the experiment with the help of your own gadgets. So using your computer or using your mobile phone, you can perform this experiment. Even though you are in a remote place, you can perform and you can study theoretically. You can understand the simulation by theoretically. Then you will be getting an exposure how to handle high voltage laboratory. That is a great thing. So that is why this virtual laboratory will help us to conduct different experiments related to high voltage engineering. Okay. So that is why virtual laboratory is required. If you perform simulation, you will be getting better understanding. So that is why this kind of high voltage laboratory is required. You please go through this. Then learning objective. Main learning objective, you need to understand the theoretical concept very clearly by conducting the virtual lab experiment. That is why we will be conducting or we will be learning this virtual lab. Then salient features. You will be having a real-time experience. Definitely as if we are doing a real-time experiment. We will be getting some exposure such a way that as if we will be conducting some kind of real-time experiment. That's why we will be depending on this virtual lab. Okay, now let us conduct the experiment. First you click on list of experiment in the second option. I'll be clicking on list of experiments. Soon after clicking on list of experiment, I'll be getting the options. You can see the options. The following experiments are developed. First one is study of impulse voltage generator. Second one, parametric analysis of impulse voltage waveform. Third one is study of impulse current generator.
Parametric analysis of impulse current waveform, critical flashover of a spear gap using impulse voltage generator, study of rectangular pulse current generator, functioning of voltage doubler, three-stage Cockcroft-Walton type multiplier. These are the different experiments they have developed.
So first and foremost thing, I'll be showing you how to conduct the experiment on study of impulse voltage generator, IVG. They have written IVG. Okay, impulse voltage generator means IVG. Abbreviation is IVG. Now let us move on to the first experiment. Study of impulse voltage generator. Please click on the experiment on study of impulse voltage generator.
I have clicked the study of impulse voltage generator option. Then I'll be getting the basic introduction. Introduction of impulse voltage generator. What do you mean by impulse voltage generator? Why do you conduct experiment on impulse voltage generator? What are the basic requirement of conducting the impulse voltage generator? What are the basic applications of impulse voltage generator?
Please refer my video before doing the simulation. Kindly refer my videos on impulse voltage generator. I tried to convince you in a better manner. So kindly watch.
Now let us do the simulation first.
So there are different options. Introduction, theory, objective, simulator, procedure, application, then references and quizzes. What I require, I need simulator. So please click on simulator. Please click on the fourth option, that is simulator.
Whenever I click on the simulator, I can see the graphical view.
I can see the graphical view of multi-stage impulse generator. We are having different stages and we can observe the spear gap. And of course, the whole setup will be 100% similar to the structure of impulse voltage generator. We feel as if we conduct a real-time experiment. That's a peculiarity of this virtual lab.
So let us consider this simulator first. You need to consider the simulator.
Now we can perform the experiment in virtual lab. So what you can do is, in the bottom side you can observe IVG simulator. IVG is nothing but impulse voltage generator. And of course you can click IVG simulator. Please click on IVG simulator. Okay, I'll be clicking on IVG simulator.
Okay, soon after I clicked on IVG simulator, then I'll be getting the options like this.
In the left side, you can see the controller. In the right side, different options are there. Simulator, instructions and equivalent circuit diagram. If you want, you can read out the instructions. So click on the instruction option. Then in that instruction, you can read many things. What are the things we have to follow while doing the experiment? So what about the variation of spear gap or spar gap? Spear gap can be varied in between 0.1 to 7 centimeter. Similarly, VO in kilovolt, that means charging voltage that can be varied till 30 kV. That's a peculiarity. Okay, you can read out the instructions. It will really help you to make out how to calculate wavefront time and how do you calculate wave tail time. Wavefront time and wave tail time I already explained. You can go through that. What is wavefront, what is wave tail, everything I explained. So those concepts they have given and you can go through that.
Similarly, equivalent circuit diagram. For your reference, they have given equivalent circuit diagram.
So this is this diagram depicts the real-time view of impulse voltage generator, the pictorial representation, or you can say circuit diagram. This is a circuit diagram of impulse voltage generator. We can see the input supply, then ground switch, then you can observe different stages. And you can see different type of spear gap, like in between there are two spear or spark. You can observe that is known as spark gap. They have placed in a serial manner.
Similarly, in the output you can see the capacitors. Okay, then finally output voltage will be collected. Test object is also there. You can see the test object and the final spark gap. So this is a typical view of equivalent circuit diagram of multi-stage impulse voltage generator. Multi-stage impulse voltage generator.
You can observe in the circuit diagram. Okay, so we have in the extreme left side you can see AC supply, then rectifier, later ground switch, then different stages, n number of stages. You can connect n number of stages. That's a peculiarity of mux generator or impulse voltage generator. Then you can see the capacitors, later capacitors and resistors, just like RC potential divider. What do we mean by RC potential divider? I will explain in the third module. Then at the end you can observe the spark gap. Okay, so this is a equivalent circuit of multi-stage impulse voltage generator. Now let us go for the simulator. So click on the simulator. Once you click the simulator, you will be getting the graphical view of impulse voltage generator.
So you can, if you want, you can rotate. Okay, you can rotate and you can move many options are there. It depends on your convenience. You can rotate or you can tilt. Many options are there. Now let us look at the controller part. First, what they have given is charging voltage. They have given 10 volt. Okay, if you want, you can increase the voltage also. So I'll be increasing the voltage slightly. 18 volt. I'll be giving 18 volt. So you can slider is there. By using the slider, you can increase the particular charging voltage. Similarly, CG in microfarad. CG is nothing but the generator capacitance. If you want, you can reduce the value, or if you want, you can increase the value. Depends. So I'll be increasing the value. 0.608 microfarad. Then regarding C1 is the input capacitor. So if you want, you can increase. So I'll be giving 0.0034 microfarad. Then next is resistor value. That is most important, depends on the output shape. To control the shape of output, this value plays crucial role. RF is nothing but wavefront resistance, and RT is nothing but wavetail resistance. If you adjust the wavefront and wavetail, obviously what we can say, the shape will be varied. So I can adjust. So time being, I'll be taking the same value what they have given, that is 15 ohm as well as 115 ohm. And let it be. If you want, you can practice it different values of resistors, and you can check the output. Definitely you can say that the resistor value, that is depending on the shape of impulse waveform. Okay, so whenever you are selecting the value of RF and RT, that is most crucial to get the desired value of wave shape, to get the desired wave shape. That is most important, that you can verify thereafter. Now spear gap, they have given 7. So I'll be giving almost 7.7. I'll be giving 7.7. Okay. Now let us start the experiment. We have given the control parameters. These are the control parameter which I need to give. Thereafter you can start the experiment. So first you click on start experiment. Later second option, go to second option, open ground switch. I have clicked open ground switch. Thereafter I need to charge the capacitor. First of all, I would like to charge the capacitor. That's the third procedure. So click on third option, that is charge capacitor. Charge capacitors. Please click on the option. Charge capacitors. Now you can see capacitors are getting charged. You can see the options also in the top side. Then I could come to know that capacitors are charged completely. Thereafter you can trigger the generator. Please click on the fourth option, that is trigger generator. Okay, I'll be clicking on fourth option, that is trigger the generator. Now you can see the spark gap. It has been triggered. See, that means impulse voltage generator has been operated successfully. Then you are able to get the waveform also. This waveform represents the output of impulse voltage generator. This is actually impulse waveform. During lightning and thundering, these kind of waves will be formulating. In this impulse voltage generator, what you can say that capacitors are getting charged in parallel and discharged in serial fashion. Okay, so that you will be getting the impulse waveform in this manner. Then check the observation. What are the observations you made? Peak voltage in kilovolt, that is 29.77 volt. Kilovolt, that is expressed in terms of kilovolt. Then wavefront time in microsecond, that is given by 0.5 microsecond. Similarly, wavetail time is also given by 51 microsecond. That is a obtained value. So you can note down. This can be conducted as an experiment for high voltage engineering theory subject. So students will get a better understanding if you conduct the experiment. Then, did you get the standard waveform for this value? Obviously, this is standard values only. I can click yes option. Okay. Now, if you want to save the graph, then if you want to take the printout or if you want to paste in your record, then you can save it first. So, I need to click on save graph. So, download. Yes, I have got the value. Then if I want, I can convert in my printer. I can connect with my printer. I can take the printout. VT curve. In the y-axis, you'll be having voltage, output to voltage in kilovolt. And x-axis, we'll be having the time in microsecond. You can observe. Then output to voltage obtained is 18 kV. Then CG, generator capacitance selected. Selected value of generator capacitance, that is CG. That is given by 0.608 microfarad. Then C1, input capacitor, you have chosen 0.0034 microfarad. Then wavefront resistance is equal to 15 ohm. Wavetail resistance is equal to 115 ohm. If you want to change the wave shape, obviously you need to concentrate on RF as well as RT. If you change RF and RT, obviously wave shape will be changed. This is a simulation regarding impulse voltage generator. I hope you could understand the basics of impulse voltage generator after doing the simulation.
So kindly practice for different values of R of RT, then CG, and different spear gap also. You can set the different value for values of spear gap. So check the different values of spear gap and you can conduct the experiment and you can check the output. You can measure the wavefront time, wavetail time, many parameters can be measured. So this will be really helpful those who are doing research in the area of high voltage engineering, especially impulse voltage generator. Students also will get good idea if you conduct the experiment. Theoretically anyway, we'll be speaking theoretically. In parallel, if you conduct the experiment in a virtual laboratory, definitely students will get more idea about impulse voltage generator. So thank you for watching this video. Please share and don't forget to subscribe.